am Prasanna. In this video, I am going to explain you what is quadrilateral and what are the properties of quadrilateral. Here, quadrilateral. You know what is quadrilateral? It is a simple closure figure formed by four line segments, right? Here, the word quadri. In quadrilateral, the word quad. What is mean by quad? It is originated from two Latin words, means it is four. And what about this laterals? Means it is sides. So overall quadrilateral is nothing but four sides. In geometry, a quadrilateral can be defined as a closed two-dimensional shape which has four straight sides. Okay? Quadrilateral, or a polygon. Polygon with four sides. Now coming to what is polygon? Polygon is nothing but a simple closure figure formed by line segments, right? Or we can say a simple closure figure formed by four line segments. Simple closure figure formed by four line segments, or you can say simply a polygon with four sides is called a quadrilateral, right? Or you can say quadrilateral can be defined as a closed two-dimensional shape which has four straight sides. Here, so many shapes we have in quadrilateral, children. These all are quadrilateral. Now we can find the shape of quadrilateral in various things around us, like in a chessboard, a deck of cards, a kite, etc. Coming to properties of quadrilateral, children. Here, this is a quadrilateral. The name of this quadrilateral is given A, B, C, D. Right? We have to read this name. A, B, C, D. We should go in a continuous order. You cannot read like A, B, B, C. You go in a continuous order. Quadrilateral A, B, C, D is the name of this quadrilateral. It has four vertices. What are vertices? Corners, okay? So it has four vertices and it has four angles and it has four sides. And if you see, these are the two diagonals. What is diagonal? You know, the line segment joining the opposite vertices is called a diagonal. So quadrilateral is having four vertices, four angles, four sides and two diagonals. Okay. And coming to properties in this, first property is a quadrilateral has four sides, four angles and four vertices. Quadrilateral has four sides, four angles, four vertices. Okay. Next property is a quadrilateral can be regular or irregular. Regular or irregular. Now tell me what is regular. Regular means a figure in which all sides are equal and all angles are equal, then we can say it is a regular. Right? So irregular means opposite to regular, having different measurement. Okay? Regular means having same shape. Okay? Same size, equal size and equal angles. Right? Now coming to third property, the sum of all the interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360. The sum of all the interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360. So these are the properties of quadrilateral. Means first one, a quadrilateral has four sides, four angles, four vertices. A quadrilateral can be regular or irregular, and sum of all the interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360. Now next I am going to show what are sides, what are angles, what are vertices in a quadrilateral. Now consider the quadrilateral ABCD, children. Now I am going to write here slowly what are vertices. So what are vertices here? Vertices are nothing but corners. So So A comma B comma C comma D are the vertices. Coming to next angles. So angles can be written with a single letter or with three letters. So first I'll write with single letter angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D. Now how do you represent angle A in three letters? Here you can write angle A as DAB or BAD. Always the vertex should be in the middle, right? So how do you write angle A as your wish? DAB. Next angle B, how do you write children? You can write like ABC or CBA. Your wish. ABC. You should consider the middle letter. Always the vertex should be in the middle. Next, how do you write C? B, C, D. Next, how do you write D? C, D, A. So these are the angles. Coming to sides. Sides are nothing but line segments. Okay. So four sides you are having: AB, BC, CD, DA. These are the four sides. Four line segments are known as four sides of a quadrilateral. Next, coming to diagonals. What are diagonals, children? Diagonals are nothing but the line segment joining opposite vertices. So these are the opposite, no? A and C and D and B are the opposite vertices. So a line segment joining opposite vertices is called diagonal. So how many diagonals quadrilateral has now? Only two diagonals, that is AC and BD. So these are the diagonals. Coming to next, we are going to write adjacent sides. Adjacent means what? Side to side, okay, having common vertex. Here we will get four pairs of adjacent sides here. Like AB is adjacent to BC. Next BC is adjacent to CD. CD is adjacent to DA. DA is adjacent to AB. So you will get four pairs. That is AB is adjacent to BC, right? Next BC is adjacent to CD. I am writing one pair in bracket, children. Next CD is adjacent to DA. Next DA is adjacent to AB. So total you are going to get four pairs of adjacent sides. Next is adjacent angles. So you can write angles either in three letters or with single letter. So here angle A and angle B are in adjacent angles. Okay. Next angle B, angle C are adjacent. Next angle C, angle D are adjacent. Next angle D and angle A are adjacent. If you want to write in three letters, you can write children. Here angle A can be written as how? Angle A can be written as D A B. Angle B can be written as A B C. Similarly, angle B can be written as A B C. Angle C can be written as B C D. Similarly, next angle C can be written as B C D. D can be written as C D A. Next angle D can be written as C D A. Next A can be written as D A B. Okay. So total we are going to get four pairs of adjacent angles. Next coming to opposite sides. So adjacent sides you will get four pairs, but opposite sides you will get only two. That is AB is opposite to DC and AD is opposite to BC. So total only two pairs. AB and DC are opposite sides. Next AD and BC are opposite sides. Next coming to opposite angles. Opposite angles. You know, angle A is opposite to angle C, angle B is opposite to angle D. So angle A and angle C are opposite angles, and angle B and angle D are opposite angles. So you can write the single letters with three letters, children. Or angle A can be written as how? A B A B. B A B comma. Next angle C can be written as B C D. Next B and D. What is B? A, B, C, comma, angle. Angle A, B, C, comma, what is D? Angle C, D, A. So these are the opposite angles. 4 by 4 line segment. Now first, in types of quadrilateral, first one we are going to discuss about trapezium. So what is trapezium? It is also a quadrilateral. So this is the shape of the trapezium will be like this. Okay. Right? It is a four-sided figure and it is a closed figure. Then what is the trapezium? What is the speciality of a trapezium? So a quadrilateral in which, definition I am writing, a quadrilateral in which one pair of opposite sides are parallel. So total how many pairs of opposite sides you are going to get, some children? Two pairs. This side opposite, and this is opposite. So I am writing name here. Suppose it is A, B, C, D. In this, if you see, the opposite sides are AB and DC, AD and BC. But AD is like this, BC is like this. Can I say these two lines are opposite? No. What about AB and DC? AB is like this, DC is like this. They are parallel. So here, which are parallel here? AB is parallel to DC, right? So a quadrilateral in which one pair of opposites, only one pair of opposites are parallel, then we call it as a trapezium. Okay, in this figure, which are parallel lines here? AB is parallel to DC and AD is not parallel to BC, right? And so we are having only one property. So property is sum of the adjacent angles of a non-parallel sides of a trapezium is supplementary or 180. Non-parallel sides. Here, what are the non-parallel sides here? AD and BC. So we can take that angle A plus angle D equal to 180 or angle B plus angle C equal to 180. This is the only one property. Sum of the adjacent angles of a non-parallel sides of a trapezium is 180. Or simply we can see, children, if DC and AB are like this, and what is DA here? It is like transversal. And if I see angles, these are, what are these two angles here? Interior angles on the same side of a transversal. When the two lines are parallel, we can say the interior angles on the same side of a transversal are supplementary. If you consider this also, AB and DC, and what about this BC is a transversal. If I take these two angles, these are also interior angles from the same side of a transversal. When the two lines are parallel, we can say the sum of the interior angles from the same side of a transversal is 180. Next one is parallelogram. A quadrilateral in which both pairs of opposite sides are parallel. This is the shape of parallelogram. If you see, suppose if it is ABCD, AB is parallel to DC and AD is also parallel to BC. Here, both pairs, only two pairs of opposite sides you are going to get. In the two pairs are parallel, then we call it as a parallelogram. So, here is the definition, a quadrilateral in which two pairs of opposite sides are parallel. Two pairs of opposite sides are parallel. So this is called a parallelogram. Okay. And what are the properties of parallelogram here? In parallelogram, here opposite sides are equal. Means this side is equal to this side. And single line, okay, and this side is equal to this side. For example, if it is 5 centimeters, AB is 5 centimeters in the parallelogram, we can take DC is also 5 centimeters. are opposite angles also equal in parallelogram. This angle is equal to this angle and this opposite angles are equal. For example, if A is 60, we can say take C as a 60. So very important properties we are having here. Properties. First one, opposite sides are equal. Next property, opposite angles are equal. Next, third one, here if you see the diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. So you know AC and BD are the diagonals. So diagonals bisect. What do you mean by bisect, children? It divides equally, okay? So diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. Diagonals bisect each other. And one more property is there in parallelogram. Sum of adjacent angles are supplementary. Means in parallelogram we can take angle A plus angle B as 180, angle B plus angle C as 180, angle C plus angle D as 180, angle D plus angle A is also 180. So here we can take sum of adjacent angles is 180. So, four important properties in parallelogram, children. Opposite sides are equal, opposite angles are equal, diagonals bisect each other, and the sum of the adjacent angles is 180. Next, third one is rhombus. Before discussing rhombus, I want to draw flowchart here, children. See, first is quadrilateral. So type first one we discussed about. Trapezium. So trapezium is nothing but only one pair of opposite sides are parallel. Next we discuss about parallelogram. What is parallelogram? In which both pairs of opposite sides are parallel. Okay. Now based on parallelogram it divides again into two types. One is called, now what you are discussing now? Rhombus. So it comes under with the parallelogram. So what is the definition of rhombus, children, here? A parallelogram in which adjacent sides are equal. Which adjacent sides are equal. Means it is like parallelogram only, but in parallelogram opposite sides are equal. In rhombus its adjacent sides are equal. Means the shape of a parallelogram will be like this. This side is parallel to this side, this side is parallel to this side. Now suppose if it is A, B, C, D, okay. Now in this, this side is adjacent, B, C and C, D are adjacent, so they are equal. C, D and D are adjacent, so they are equal. D and A, B are adjacent, so they are equal. A, B and B, C are also adjacent. Equal. So by this we got in rhombus all the four sides are equal. Is that clear, children? So in that first property is all sides are equal. See, if you see, you can see it is also parallelogram because AD is parallel to BC and DC is also parallel to AB. Opposite sides are parallel. But coming to here, a parallelogram in which adjacent sides are equal gives you rhombus. So by this we can say in rhombus all sides are equal. Now same like parallelogram, only opposite angles are equal. All sides are equal, right? Next, what about these diagonals? If you draw the diagonals AC and BD, the diagonals bisect each other. What is mean by bisect? Dividing into two equal parts. Bisect each other perpendicularly. Perpendicularly means what? It bisects at 90 degrees. So in rhombus, other properties, diagonals bisect each other perpendicularly. Okay, this is the, these are the properties of rhombus. Next one is rectangle. So rectangle can also be formed by parallelogram also, parallelogram only. So shape of rectangle, you know children, so this is the shape of rectangle. So rectangle is also a parallelogram in which each angle is a 90 degrees. That is the definition. So in parallelogram all angles are different. These angles are not 90. So in rectangle each angle is 90. So it is like same parallelogram, like opposite sides are equal, right? Now but only difference is in rectangle all the angles are 90 degrees, right? So what is the definition here? A parallelogram in which one angle is right angle, then it forms a rectangle. What is mean by one angle here? So when one angle is 90, the all other angles also become 90. I will show you how. So the rectangle shape is what? This is the shape of rectangle. Suppose A, B, C, D. So a parallelogram, it is like parallelogram. See, if you see what are the properties of parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. In rectangle also AB and CD are equal. Like in parallelogram, here AD and BC also equal, right? Parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. Now parallelogram in which one angle is 90. So if it is 90, then what about C? C will also be 90, because in parallelogram opposite angles are equal. And in parallelogram sum of the two adjacent angles equal to 180. Similarly here also A plus B is also 180. If angle A is 90, then what about B? It will also 90. If B is 90, what about D? It will also 90. Is that clear, children? So in rectangle, what did you observe now? All the angles of a rectangle is 90 degrees. Is that clear? Now coming to properties, same like parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. What about angles? All angles is 90 degrees. All angles is 90. Next, what about diagonals? Coming to diagonals, in rectangle, the main important point is the diagonals are equal. Diagonals are equal in rectangle. Means if the diagonal AC is 10 centimeters, then you can say diagonal BD is also 10 centimeters, because in rectangle diagonals are equal. And one more property, same like parallelogram, diagonals bisect each other. Here also diagonals bisect each other. So four properties in rectangle. Next, fifth one is square. So square can be derived from both, children. It is derived from rhombus and from rectangle. So this is the square, and you know very well what is square. Square is all sides are equal. So we can write two definitions. Based on rhombus, a square is a rhombus in which each angle is 90 degrees. Because it is like rhombus, only in rhombus all sides are equal. Similarly for square also all sides are equal. Then what is the difference between rhombus and square? In rhombus all sides are not equal, but in square all the angles are 90 degrees. Coming to this, we can compare square with rectangle also. Right, rectangle opposite sides are equal, in square also opposite sides are equal. Then what is the difference? It is square is a rectangle in which all angles are 90 degrees. Right, all adjacent sides are equal. Here, if this side and this side is equal, then it will become a square. So we can write two definitions here. One is a square is a rectangle with adjacent sides are equal, or a square is a rhombus. Square is a rhombus in if each angle is 90. Okay, so you know the shape of square. Square, this is ABCD. In this, all sides are equal, and if you see, all the angles are 90 degrees. Is that clear? And what about these diagonals properties? I am going to write here. First one, all sides are equal. Next property, all angles is 90 degrees. Then what about the diagonals? Same like rectangle, only diagonals are equal and diagonals bisect each other. Diagonals are equal. And fourth property, diagonals bisect each other. So these are the properties of square. Next one, kite. See, kite is derived with a quadrilateral. So this is the shape of a kite. So definition of kite is a quadrilateral with adjacent sides are equal. One pair of adjacent sides are equal, or consecutive also you can say. A quadrilateral with exactly two pairs of equal consecutive sides. So shape of a kite is a quadrilateral, isn't it? Because it is a simple closure figure formed by four line segments. If I take A, B, C, D, this side is equal to this side, means with exactly two pairs of equal consecutive sides. So total four sides. So in this, one pair of equal sides, and this side is equal to this side. So here AB is equal to AD, BC is equal to DC. So this forms a kite. Right, coming to properties, first one, diagonals. What about diagonals here? The diagonals are equal here. If you see, AC is bigger and BD is smaller diagonal, but these two diagonals bisect perpendicularly. So first one is the diagonals bisect perpendicular, means here the diagonals are perpendicular, not bisecting. The diagonals are perpendicular. First one, diagonals are perpendicular. Here they are not bisecting because AC is bigger and BD is smaller. Next one, the diagonals are equal here. No, the diagonals are not equal. Not equal. If you see, AC bisects BD, the longer diagonal bisects the smaller diagonal. So here the last property is, one of the diagonals bisect each other, or longer diagonal bisects the smaller diagonal. So these are the properties of a kite.